I know those boxes are ugly, but I want to show you in this lesson how to use links and actions. Links can make us, for example, something like that. We can make a navigation, then we can make a button back to navigation, we will click on it, and it will bring us back. This is just example usage, and I'll explain you more in detail in this lesson. Now, if you would like to make a simple navigation with an example slide like this, this would be our navigation, I could show you the trick. We can use both links and actions. Let me show you how they work. Now, let's imagine this would be a shape. Now, I will not design this shape super properly, but I want to show you how this works. Slide 5, for example, slide 20. Oh, we don't even have 20 slides. Great. Slide 8 and slide 12. You can click on any given object. You can go to insert and you can utilize links. If you click on link, and for example, you can link to an existing file on your PC or on web, you can link to a place in this very document, which will be of course this presentation, or create a new document or an email address, but most often you will want to link to another slide. What did we write here? Slide 5. Okay, let's say that this would be the beginning of a new section. We have a new section at slide 6, but that doesn't matter, it's only an example. Okay, now this object is hyperlinked and it already works. Let me just be clear, make another link for slide 8. Okay, great. And on the last slide, I made it bigger because I want to show you something. Apart from links, you can also use actions. Actions, I would call them a bit more advanced, but in the way that they have more options. We can have actions on mouse click, which would do basically the same, or we can have actions on mouse over, meaning when the mouse hovers over this object. I'll press mouse over, I will select hyperlink to, well, instead of next slide, what I want slide number 12. Okay, not 13, 12. 12. Alright, and now see how that works. I'll press Shift and F5 to start the presentation from this slide, and I have to care, because once I hover my mouse over this, it will automatically change to the slide I wanted. So you need to be very, very careful when it comes to actions. I'll go once again here to format actions, because actions are not only on mouse click, I could make them on mouse click, but they can also be made on mouse over. Those, however, are simple links. As you can see, we can click and we can go to this slide. Well, it automatically shoots us to the next slide, but the same goes for the slide 5 and slide 8. When it comes to the action, I only have to hover my mouse, so you have to be careful if you want to use this option. You could, for example, make a back to navigation. This could look eventually like that. We would have a small back to navigation button. Maybe we should put an icon here, and I'll go to insert, link, and this would link to the second slide. Now, no matter where I am, for example, on slide 5, I would be, for example, on this slide, and I could go quickly back to navigation. Oh, you see, I accidentally hovered my mouse over this action. So you need to be very careful when it comes to actions. I hope this is useful knowledge for you. It's really amazing that we can use something like that within presentation software. And as you can see, this can be utilized in many, many ways. I hope you did enjoy this tutorial and see you in other ones like that.